Why, good morning, saints of God. How are you doing today? So good to be with you here on this Tuesday morning. Remember now, Tuesday mornings are Food Bank Tuesdays, and today we're going to have a good day at the food bank. If you have time and like to come out there and be with us, we would be so glad to have you with us. You know, Jesus used a number of teaching methods. He made use of stories, of parables. He would even raise a question to so that people would think. He kind of provoked their thinking by raising some questions. And some of his teaching was in response to questions that people asked him. But also, our Lord Jesus, he would use an object lesson all the time. And these object lessons were very powerful and very precious. In this story we read today, he used a little child. And everybody see who I have here with me? This is little Bobo Lyman, and he's just woke up. And as you see, he's already started with some breakfast here. Some blueberries, how about that? And, you know, today we come into the book of Matthew, chapter number 18. And a very interesting little situation takes place here in verse number 1. The Bible says, "And at the same time came his disciples unto Jesus, saying, Who is the greatest in heaven?" Wow, kind of a strange question when you begin to look at it. When I read it, I sometimes feel like this is somewhat of a competition that's going on between the disciples. And so I understand these disciples, they're not fully enlightened at this time. Their view of the kingdom was probably influenced by carnal political thinking of their age. So in reply to this crazy question, look what Jesus says in verse number 2. "And Jesus called a little child unto him and set him in the midst of them." Wow. You know, I'm going to tell you something. Jesus loves children. Anytime you see a child, you just remember one thing. God loves him, okay? And little Bobo here, he's helping me. Jesus and his kingdom is not about the ranking of men from greatest to least. His kingdom is not like the governments and the political administrations of men, where power and money and numbers enjoy more influence than character and virtue. Understand that. Character and virtue are far more important than money, power, and any of those things of this world system. No, I'm going to tell you something. Our king, this king and his kingdom, is about changing our life and serving our Lord. In verse number 3, the Bible says, "And said, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as a little child, ye shall not enter the kingdom of heaven." The disciples had their mind on competition instead of conversion. And here in this regard, they were enlightened by the great teacher, Jesus Christ. They were carnal and they were immature. And the king, the Messiah that we've been talking about through the book of Matthew here, Jesus and his kingdom is about changing your life, changing my life, not outdoing your brothers and sisters in Christ, but changing our life with real love, mercy, grace, and compassion. And the language is very strong. It's direct and demanding. Listen, look, let me read it again. "Except ye be converted and become as a little child, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Whosoever there shall humble himself, this little child, the same is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven." Whew. And I think it's intended for all of us to notice the necessity of conversion is illustrated here by this childlike humility, infantile humility. Babies are dependent, they are teachable, and they are innocent. Very open about their needs. So I want to tell you something. Immediately, he needed some blueberries. They are not generally clamoring to outdo other babies. No, they want to live and they want to learn. And theirs is the kingdom qualities. That's what we need. In order to be in the Lord's kingdom, I have to change. I must come face to face with my dependence. I must learn to be open about my spiritual needs and be willing to listen and learn and be governed. And this is the key, to be governed by the King of Kings in my heart, King Jesus Christ. In verse number 5, he says, "And who shall receive one such little child in my name receiveth me." Listen, I'm going to tell you something. You want to get on God's good list? You learn to love them children. I tell you, I got 6 grandbabies, and I am so thankful for them. They are precious to me. Then he says in verse 6, but whoso shall offend one of these little ones, be careful your treatment of children. Oh, be careful the way you treat a child. They are extra special to Jesus Christ. We got more blueberries coming in. We ran out of blueberries. There's the second shipment. We're doing a good job here. But whoso shall offend one of these little ones, which believe in me, it were better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck and that he were drowned in the depth of the sea. There's a song that we all should remember. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world, red and yellow, black and green, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Let's see if I can get the second verse better. Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world, red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus died for all the children of the world. But I want to tell you something. Jesus rose for all the children, all the children of the world, red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the blueberry children too, and he loves you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your goodness and your mercy to us. Father, thank you for reminding us how you love us as children. And Lord, help us to have a childlike faith and a childlike humility that trusts you and leans on you, Father, for our needs and for all that we have. Thank you for these good folks. And Father, I pray you bless them today. Be with those at the food bank, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Go serve your King. God bless you.